Hey everybody, and welcome back to another gameplay playthrough with your fun team here at Passport Game Studios. Today we're going to play Fool's Gold. This is a Passport Game Studios published game, and you've got myself, Scott Morris, who is president of Passport Game Studios. I'm here with my usual band of thieves who are going to help me search for gold in the mountains and the river and the lake. Guys, why don't you go ahead and introduce yourself, Ryan first and Chaz second.
Hi, this is Ryan. You may remember me from such playthroughs as winning Quartz and winning Simurgh. Did I win Simurgh? Maybe I didn't win Simurgh.
You came from behind in epic style.
Oh, I did. That's right. That was that really epic comeback one. That was good. So yes. I have a reputation for winning our game, so we'll see if that reigns. Yes. Who are you?
I am me. You may remember me from almost winning Simurgh and not quite winning Quartz, but Fool's Gold is actually one of my top 100 all-time favorite games, so I am here and I am ready to pyrite all night.
Oh, pyrite all night. Here he goes.
So this is where the fun begins. If anyone has not watched one of our playthroughs before, Chaz is filled with something, but he's filled with puns, and there will be a lot of them strewn throughout the recording. So if you can find them all, feel free to email us at info@passportgamestudios.com, and we'll maybe send you something special and something fun. You never know how many you can find. So what is Fool's Gold, and what are you looking at, and what are we doing? So first thing, so anyone who doesn't know, we are playing this game on Tabletopia, which is a software program that basically emulates playing a board game through your computer. Some of us are playing this through a browser. I myself am playing it through Steam Client. If you go to tabletopia.com, you can learn more about them. We have several of our games on there, and there's other publishers that have their games on there as well. It's a great service. It's a wonderful thing to be able to play with your friends who are all around the world. Like, for example, right now, Ryan is in the middle of beautiful downtown Boise, Idaho, and Eugene, Oregon is the home for Chaz, and I am in Austin, Texas. So there's no way we could physically play this game together right now if it weren't for Tabletopia. So we're looking forward to that. So what is Fool's Gold? Fool's Gold is a game where we are all miners. We're looking for gold, shockingly enough. But as you can tell with the name Fool's Gold, there's going to be some gold that's real and valuable and some gold that's not. The game is played over two phases. We're going to have a prospecting phase and we're going to have a mining phase. We're going to talk a little bit about the prospecting phase first and then jump right into that, and we'll explain some of the idiosyncrasies and the little subtleties of the game as we go along. Just to give you guys a quick outline, though, you can see here there's five different decks. There are the hills, the forest, the mountains, the river, and the lake. Each one of these decks represents a different mine. And right now, Ryan is going through and shuffling them digitally. As we roll dice and place dice along the mine's pathways, and as we use our workers on our boards to place workers, we're going to gain access to these mines, which could provide us with valuable gems or with gold. We all have a player board in front of us that is going to give a breakdown. You'll notice on the screen right now, it shows all five of the decks, and then it also shows how many cards in that deck are represented by the type. So for example, in the hills, it shows there are four cards that have a single gold nugget. There are five cards that have two gold nuggets, and there are seven cards that have three gold nuggets, but alas, there are no cards with four and five gold nuggets. There are 15 silt cards, there are six gems, there are three false alarms, and there are three foul weathers. What does all that mean? We'll explain as we get going. But right now, Ryan, why don't you tell us about the four actions that we have access to during the prospecting phase?
Sure. So at the start of each round, we're going to, which is called a year in Fool's Gold, we're going to play over 5 years. And at the start of each year, we determine the first player, at the start of the game, we determine the first player by whoever has the most gold teeth, which I can't really speak to having any myself.
I have zero. it's
possible that we just roll a die here to determine the first player. So
sure.
Why don't I have one.
Let's do that first.
I have
let's
one.
Roll the winter. You have one gold tooth?
I do.
You do?
Oh, well, then Chaz is first player.
There we have no way of verifying that, but we'll trust you on that.
My sister is a dentist, and I was her final project at dentistry school.
I guess that's better than the first project.
Yeah.
Awesome. Right, well, then so Chaz is going to be the first player.
The blue player is going to take the large pickaxe, which is our first player token. I'll put it over there in front of Chaz. And what's going to happen here during the prospecting phase is the first player is going to roll all the prospecting dice, which are all the blue dice you see in the middle of the game board. After he does that, the dice will be allocated to their respective mining locations based on the number listed. So the hills are number one, the forest number two, and so forth and so on. But Daz, why don't you go ahead and give him a roll, and let's go ahead and have you distribute those dice accordingly.
Rolled.
There roll.
Oops. Hey, let go of.
You don't put them all in one place.
There we go. I need to remember to click off of them first.
All right, so a couple things will happen here. Is first, he starts filling in the action spaces with the corresponding dice. So number ones all go here, and we have four number ones, so we go all the way up to the number two. If at any of the locations we were to exceed that spot number two and go into the spot number three and beyond, all of those dice are instead returned to the center as sixes and become wild dice, and we'll get how those can be used a little bit later. So he's going to be allocating these dice. You'll notice we have no twos rolled. That means that the location, which is the forest that corresponds to dice number two, is not available to us during this year, at least at this point. That
Chaz
should
is
change.
Also manipulating the dice.
Oh, Chaz.
If you actually,
you can pick it up.
Yeah, you can,
my first turn.
You can write the dice down and you can choose to put it on a specific number if you wanted to.
Yeah, Tabletopia is pretty cool. The dice will actually have a bit of memory as far as how it was last rolled. So even if it tips over because of physics, if you just pick it up, it should right side itself to the last number that it was rolled.
Okay, I nominate that we don't let Chaz put the dice out anymore because he's not doing very well with the whole snapping thing.
Nope, we got them. That was good. They're good. All right. So the prospecting phase starts with this. And so we have done the first step of the prospecting phase. The next step is that starting with the first player, which will be Mr. Blue Chaz, he's going to have four different actions he can choose one of that he has to do one of. Scott, if you're able from your perspective to zoom in on your player board for a moment.
I've got it pulled up.
Quick, great. So the first action that you can take is to place one of your workers, which we're going to have behind a virtual player screen. Once we get into the game here, we're going to hide the content that is on our respective boards so people will not be able to see how many workers or money we have. But for the moment, we'll leave that as is. So we'll take one of your workers from behind the screen, and you can place it to any of the available locations. So again, the forest is currently not available because there are no dice there leading the way for us. So to place a worker in a location, you pay a number of coins from your current supply, which we all start with six. To the value of the location you want to put yourself in. So if I wanted to go to the hills, the first available location is going to cost me three coins. Those three coins actually go not to the bank. They just leave from behind my screen, and I'm going to get them all back at the end of the round. I'm going to have $6 every year to spend and have a potential to earn more from some actions, which we will get to a little bit later. Next thing you can do is, instead of placing one of your workers, is you can use one of the wild dice, if there are any available. In this first round, as you can see, there are no wild dice, which are the sixes in the middle, so we will not be able to take the faction during the first year. But it allows us to place that die onto one of the location's paths and potentially grant access to a location that was not previously available, or make another location potentially more valuable, and we'll get to why that is in a little bit. The third option is to take one of the workers from behind your player screen and place it in front of your player screen to regain three of the dollars you have already spent this year. So that allows you to have some extra money to spend on placing workers onto different locations. And last but not least is to pass your turn. And passing allows you to take all of your money and your workers back that are left in front of you and take anything that is still behind your screen and allocate them to the board as reserve miners to any of the locations as you see fit. And when we get to the mining phase, we will explain more about how those things are utilized. So that is all the action for prospecting. So I think I have talked enough. I think it's time to let Chaz take his first turn.
Yep. The key right now so... in prospecting is to remember that you want to end the prospecting phase with the majority of your miners at a location. If you do, you are going to get first pick from the cards that are going to be revealed. And there's going to be a different amount of cards revealed depending on the number of players and the number of dice that have been placed there. If you do not have majority, or if you tie for majority, the tie is broken by who is furthest up the track. So you'll see as the game progresses, we're going to be cajoling and jockeying into positions of trying to either have the most people or be further up the track at different situations to get different cards. The final thing to note, and Ryan made point of this, you'll notice on our player boards there's these little eye icons in the upper left, the eyeball icons. When they are shown the way they are right now with the open eye, we can all see what's on our player boards. So as you can see on my screen, I see the four meeples and the six coins on everyone's player boards. But if we go ahead and right-click and do hide content or hit the F key and flip them over, you'll notice now, because you're looking at my screen, you can see what's on my board, but you can't see what is on Chaz and Ryan's board. And that's a really neat thing that Tabletopia does to allow you to have that hidden type presence of things. So we all know what we start the game with, but as we move on, we're going to get some more interesting things here as to how much money we have and how much meeples we have available to us. So now I've talked too much. Chaz, go prospecting.
All right, now it's my turn to talk too much. So I'm looking at the board state here, and I know that the more dice that are in a location, the greater the potential of more cards being flipped off of the piles when we come to the mining phase. So I think I am going to spend, let me grab my coins here. I'm going to spend three coins, put them in front of my screen. Can you guys see them now?
Yes.
Yep.
And I'm going to move Mr. Miner right here to spot number three in front of the river, because the river has a pretty good gold to silt ratio there. So I'm going to try and get in on that action.
Well, you actually have to spend, is it two or three? Can he go wherever he wants to, or can he only go on the next available space?
You can go to any unoccupied space any available mine by paying the amount of coin.
Yep. So that's a good move.
When you put a wild dice, the wild dice has to go in the lowest space.
Correct.
I see only one coin that has moved off of your board, however, Chaz.
What's up there, cheapo? You only moved one coin.
Here, hold on. There should be. I'm going to put them to the right of my board.
Sure.
Probably a good idea, yeah.
The virtual player screen might have still been masking a couple of those coins for us.
Do you see three of them now?
I see three coins now, yes.
Cool.
Now,
all right.
I know. Foiled. That while you have more dice on a location, it does potentially lead to more cards being flipped over. But I also know that the more cards you flip over, the greater the risk is, because you could run into foul weather or you could run into false alarms. So that can get kind of tricky. So I'm actually only going to spend one coin and put that off to the right. And I am going to put one of my miners, Miner Bob, over here at the lake. And he's going to go right there.
All right. All right. Seems good. Seems good. I'm going to take advantage of the fact that no one has gone to the mountain, and going to the mountain is currently free if I place myself on this zero spot. So there you go. I'm going to spend no money to explore the mountains.
This is very true. Well, that's a good move.
Wow, that was completely not what I expected. you got Yellow Miner and you got Bob the Miner. So since Miner Bob went to the lake, I'll take my guy, I'll spend two, and I guess I'll take Miner Threat. I'll take him over to spot number two.
Love Miner Threat.
At the river.
We're not talking about music, are we?
That's pretty good. Okay. All right, so you're going after the river then. I'm all in on the river. So that's
I'm going up the river.
But I'm going to go to the lake. I'm going to keep increasing my opportunities on the lake. So I'm going to give up two coins.
That's all wet.
It is, but it's where all the gold is going to end up. And I am going to put, with Miner Bob, Miner Benjamin. And he's going to go to the lake as well.
Benjamin and Bob, huh?
Bob all right. And Ben.
Okay, I'm going to go ahead and take four of my coins placed to the right of my screen. And I'm going to join Chaz here at the river.
Look at that.
Ooh.
Seems pretty good.
Okay, well, I'm going to spend one and get in on some mountain action here, since it's still relatively cheap, and we're going to have now two cards coming off.
That seems pretty good.
Okay, that seems all right.
I myself am also going to spend one, two, and I am going to join you guys at the mountains.
Hi.
Nice.
Go right up there. And that's going to be Minor Mary.
Minor Mary. Okay. I'm going to use my action to expend a worker to regain three of my dollars. Oops.
Seems like a good option.
So now I can use my fourth and final worker for something a little more lucrative.
Okay. I'm going to take my last guy, and I'm going to basically pass for the rest of the round. And when you pass, you take all the miners you still have in your reserve, and you put them next to the decks to kind of give you a little bit more of a population advantage.
Mm-hmm.
I think I'm going to put him, this is Minor Azazoth. I'm going to put him over here by the mountains.
Not Azeroth.
Fantastic. Not Azeroth.
Not Azeroth. Okay.
Okay.
So that leaves it down to me. I, too, am going to pass. I am going to put my miner up the mountains as well.
Oh! Wow.
And that's Miner Jill. And then the other thing we do is we take all of our money back from in front of our screens and put them behind our screens again.
Yes. Yeah, you get all your money back.
Get all your money back.
And then my final worker, I am not going to pass. I'm not going to send him to a reserve spot.
Mm.
I'm going to spend three.
And go to the mountains.
And we're going to go to the mountains where nobody...
Oh, you're going to go to the hills. You're going to go to the hills.
I'm going to go to the hills. No one's at the hills, and I'm going to get to pick from four cards.
Why not? Yeah, that's a good choice. That's a really good choice. Okay, so that ends the entire first prospecting phase. So now we're going to shift over into the mining phase. And the mining phase basically has two seasons, you could call it. There's summer and there's winter, because it takes a while to mine gold. So what we're going to be doing here is having three different actions that we now take with our guys now that they're out there. So Ryan, why don't you go ahead and run us through the three actions that we're going to be able to do here?
Yeah, absolutely. So first and foremost, I'm going to explain kind of what we're going to do at each location.
Sure.
Is in numeric order, so starting at the hills and moving clockwise until we get around to the lake, we're going to reveal a number of cards from the top of the deck, one at a time, equal to the number of dice at that location, multiplied times the number of prospectors on the path. It does not count the workers that are in reserve, so the blue and red prospectors that Scott and Chaz sent to the mountains will not count towards that multiplier. So, for example, at the hills, we have one total prospector there, my yellow guy, times four dice, and we're going to reveal four cards. We'll reveal none at the forest. We'll reveal a total of three cards at the mountains. We'll reveal a total of nine cards at the river, because there are three workers and three dice. Okay. And we'll reveal four cards at the lake, because we've got two workers and two dice. So, we resolve each location by revealing those cards and then having workers take actions in a priority order based on the majorities that we talked about earlier. So the actions you can take is to remove one of your workers from the path, to collect either a gold nugget card from that location that has been revealed or a gem card. There is a different type of gem available in each location, and you can only collect over the course of the game one of each gem. You are trying to get all five of the gems, so you want to send your prospectors all over the place. The gold nuggets are, of course, how we're going to score points at the end of the game. So those are very important to be able to collect. The second option is to remove one of your workers from the path and collect two additional dollars from the bank. And this is the only way to increase your budget for future years of prospecting. And the third and final option is to lay down one of your workers in the space on the path, and that is going to prepare him for winter, because winter is, as we all know, coming. So, so with that
was
said,
that a reference? I didn't get that.
No, yeah, I've never heard that said anywhere before.
Never.
Pretty subtle.
We are going to go ahead and start with the hills, I believe. Yes?
Sure. Yes.
Everyone prepared for that? So, I'm going to be our de facto dealer for these decks. So, as I mentioned, we're going to deal one card at a time, because if we hit things like foul weather, it's going to affect how many cards we're going to have access to. So, again, we take our multiplication of four dice times one worker, four cards. First card from the hills is going to be a garnet, one of the gems. Second card is some silt that is not valuable to anyone. Third card is another garnet.
Nice.
The fourth card is more silt. So there you go.
So you're clearly going to choose one of the silt.
So now, as an action, I can either remove this worker to collect one of the garnets, or silt if I want it to be bad. Or I could remove him to get $2, or I could lay him down and stay longer and continue in the hills into winter if I think I have better odds of getting something that I want during winter phase.
I think you have fairly good odds right now.
I think I do as well, so I'm not going to wait until winter. We're going to take a garnet, and we're going to take it into my hand. Mm-hmm. That's going to remove this worker and put him back behind my player screen.
And that is that when Ryan did that, his little icon next to his player thing says that he has one card in his hand.
Okay, so we are wrapping up at the hills. Now that there are no workers left on the path, we take any cards that were not collected and we return them to the deck. Since we're not doing a winter phase, since there is no one prepping for winter there, we can just return them to the deck, and this will all get reshuffled at the start of each round, so we don't know when things are coming up. So in fact, I'll just go ahead and do a different shuffle to the hills now.
Sure.
And we're good to go for the next round.
And then these four dice can go back to the center, actually, as well.
Yeah, yeah. You can go ahead and return the dice now to the middle of the board.
Yep.
So, all right. Next up, we would do the forest, but we have no dice and no prospectors there, so we'll get the forest. And we come to the mountains. So, as we mentioned earlier, we take our multiplication of three prospectors on the path times one die, and we're going to reveal three cards to see what all of us are going to be vying for here. So, starting with card number one, we have one gold nugget from the mountains. Our first gold nugget. We have a false alarm, which we'll get to how those work in just a moment. And finally, we have some silt.
Oh, this is okay. Going to be an interesting little hand.
All right. So false alarms are representative of us doing our prospecting and coming up with something we think might be valuable, but then it's really not. And so what happens here is we take all these cards and we restack them. We're going to mix them back up. One moment here. And one of these cards is going to be turned over to the bottom of the deck. And let's see what we are left with.
Oh!
Lost our one gold nugget. So
33%
that
chance.
That is going to now kind of dictate how people are going to act.
Right. So I
action.
Get to go first, actually.
Yeah,
in
it's going to go to Scott. Because he has a tied majority with Chaz, but yep. You are further up on the path.
This is correct. I think I am actually going to pull my guy back and get two coins.
All right.
So I will take two coins from the bank, and I will put them on my player screen.
There you go.
That,
all right.
That didn't pan out. I'm going to do the same thing. Pull my guy back and get two coins as well.
Really? Okay. Well, I'm going to...
Are you going to lay down and rest for winter?
We're gonna stick it out for winter. So I'm going to lay down.
Good idea.
So the way winter works is now these cards are all discarded, or they put on the bottom of the deck, rather. And now the person who is furthest up, who still has people for winter, which I'm the only person, rolls the winter die, which is the white die you can see at the top of the board here. And the number that I roll is how many additional cards are going to be dealt that we then go through a second phase of mining for this location. So
just so everybody knows real quick, when in Tabletopia, if you drop something on top of the deck, you're placing it on top. If you hold the shift key, you'll see this little symbol pop up that shows kind of underneath, and that puts cards or items underneath the stack or underneath the deck that you're playing with.
Very important for a lot of games, and this one in particular, to make sure that when we go to winter, we're not just redrawing the same cards.
Hey, again. You rolled three. That's pretty good.
And I rolled a three.
I'm sure
I
you could get three sold.
We do these one at a time, just like during the summer, and see what happens here.
Oh, there's one silt.
We got more silt.
Oh, nice.
Three gold nuggets and no bad weather. This is great. Okay, so winter was good to me.
Winter came
and went, and I'm going
to
go ahead and remove that that guy, and he's going to pick up three gold nuggets for me. These now return to the deck. You guys can take your reserve workers back. We will reshuffle the mountains and move on to the river.
All right.
The
river's going to be a big one because we have 9 cards we're going to be revealing.
Yeah, this is a lot.
Three prospectors with 3 dice. So, one at a time here, we're going to get 4 gold nuggets.
That's pretty good.
5
gold nuggets.
Uh-oh, false alarm.
False alarm.
Foul weather. Okay, so it's our first foul weather. When you encounter foul weather, what happens is we're going to reduce the number of cards drawn by 1 every time we draw foul weather. So now we're only going up to 8 cards for this location. And so we're halfway there at 4 currently.
Stormy weather.
5th card is some silt. 6th card is more silt.
Oh, I'm so glad I got out of this.
7th card is more silt.
Oh, and the final card.
8th and final card is...
Ooh, maybe I'm upset I got out of this.
Yeah. All right, so now we need to resolve the false alarm.
Yep.
So we're going to collect all the cards.
And again, you only drew 1 false alarm, so after these are all reshuffled, only 1 of them is going to be put away. So there's
correct.
Still a very good chance that the 5 gold nuggets and the gem is going to be there.
All right, we put that on the bottom of the deck. We'll take the remaining 7 cards, and there we go.
Oh, look at that. They all stayed. Right. The silt went away.
I have all the gold and the gem. So, first pick is going to go to Chaz, since he has 2 people, and I only have 1. So, Chaz, would you like money, or would you like gems? Or, you know, silt would be a fine option as well.
Well, here's the rub. You know, those nuggets are some pretty hefty points, but at the end of it, whatever location I have the most gold from, I'm going to have to discard all of those cards.
Yeah. Right. Hence, fool's gold.
It's your fool's gold. Can't be real, man.
Yeah, whatever you mine the most of, there's no way that's real.
So I'm taking, you know what? Now, okay, I'm picking first because I have 2 people. I have majority.
Yep.
Who is
right.
going to pick second?
Who's going to pick second? I'm going to pick second.
And am I going to then get a third one because I have a third guy?
Yeah, you can take an action for each worker you have there.
Yes.
So as you remove guys,
What's going to happen is you're going to remove, let's say you remove one of your guys to pick a card. Let's say you remove the second guy on the number 3 space. You'll remove him, you'll pick a card. Then remaining, there are 2 meeples, so you guys are tied. But Ryan is further up, so he would pick next. Then he would remove his guy. You would have 1 guy, you have the majority, you pick next.
Yeah, and you know the majority versus placement and number of cards can be confusing, but what's nice is as you're picking cards, you're removing a meeple off of there, which actually is nice, a nice way, nice little reminder, nice way to
always keeps the game state intact on the board and easy to check.
Yeah. I'm trying to grab that gem. Here we go. Grabbing that gem.
And
I'll take my guy with him and come here, little guy. Come to me. And there we go.
That's little guy good. Goes to your player
and you can
screen.
Put your gem into your hand by dragging down to the bottom of your screen,
yep.
and it'll disappear and show that you have a card in your hand.
All right. So now we have a tied majority. I'm ahead on the road, so I get next pick, and I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to take the 4. I'm going to kind of play into what Chaz was explaining. Is during the end game, if you have whatever location you have the most sum of gold nuggets from, you lose all those gold nuggets. So having the largest number is not necessarily best. So
that is true.
We'll pull this guy back and leave Chaz to either. He can pick up the 5 if he wants, or he could bring him back for 2 gold, or he could lay him down and try his luck in the winter.
Oh, it looks like he's going for the 5 gold.
Yes.
For the gold, all right.
And a clarification, too, on that rule about whatever you have the most nuggets from. Now, I have a gem from this location. So when it comes to the end, and say, you know, I have the most gems, or the most gold is from the river, and I got to ditch all of those. Will I also have to ditch the gem that came from the river, or do I keep that, and it's only the nuggets?
No, the gems are totally separate. Only the nuggets are affected.
Because it's only your gold that's the fool's gold. There's no fool's gems.
Yeah.
Yeah, no fool's, it's a different game. Fool's garnets.
All right. Hey, let's go to the lake, man. I am so ready for the lake. Scott is going to do
his lakey things. All right, so we're going to do four cards. Two prospectors, two dice, one at a time. We have some silt for Scott.
Don't do me like that. Come on.
We have more silt for Scott.
Don't do me like that.
I like it. There's some three
that's
nuggets.
Good. I'll take that. That's helpful.
And there is a nice gem for you.
All right. So I'm the only one there. It's fairly straightforward. I'm going to return both my guys and get the three and the gem.
Yeah,
seems like a good play for me. So I'll then pull dice back in the middle and put them on my screen. That worked out. It was a little scary at first. I was like, I'm gonna have to stick around for the winter time, but that worked out pretty well.
All right, so that ends the first year. So as you can see, we are passing the honorary first player minor pickaxe to Scott. Everyone also now collects one worker as we go into the next year. We are now into 1850, and we put an extra worker behind our screen, and we each get a dollar added to our supply behind our boards.
And now, since some of us took money in the winter phase or in the mining phase, we don't all have the same amount of money. We all have the same amount of workers, but you're not sure. You have to remember who took money and how many actions can they actually pay for.
Yep, absolutely. You are the chosen prospector.
Bada boom. Lots of wilds. Whoa.
Whoa.
Hey, this will be interesting.
All right. So the ones go on the ones. The fours and twos go on the fours and twos. There's a single five for the lake. And a lot of wilds. So as a reminder to everybody, the sixes that are wilds, that is one of the options you can take during the prospecting phase. You can place a wild die on any of the mining paths, including one that isn't open yet, and you're going to pay an amount of gold equal to the number of dice that are already there. So for example, right now, the mountains are completely closed. So if I wanted to open the mountains, I could do that by paying zero and placing a six die there. That could be really good. The other option, though, which I really kind of like, I already went to the lake and I got one of my gems, and I got three gold, so I'm pretty happy with that. I'm going to try and diversify a little bit right now. So I have a good amount of cash here. I am actually going to come up here to the river and drop my guy off, Miner Bob, for three gold. One, two, and three. And I'll move that off my board over here so you guys can see that.
Okay.
Back over to you, Mr. Passport.
All right. Ryan. Passport Ryan. I know that guy. I think I want to visit the forest. So I'm going to use a guy and just go to the zero spot for no money.
For zero. Zero is zero.
Yeah.
Alrighty then. I think I'm going to follow suit. Go to the forest as well for a penny, for a gold. There we go. Okay. Hi.
Seems I like
pretty
it.
Pretty good. I am also going to take the cheap route. I am going to place a worker in the hills for zero.
All right. I am going to use one of these wild dice.
Are you?
So I'm going to spend $1. Whoops, not $2. One moment, please. While I figure out my finances. $1. To take a wild die and place it in the forest.
Oh, now, yeah.
The value of the forest has improved.
That seems good.
Well, let's continue the trend here. And let's get three coins paid out to continue getting in on this foresty action.
Nice. Wow. Look at that. So he has majority and he's higher up.
Yeah, how long that lasts.
I am going to spend one, and I'm going to place a worker here on the hills.
All right.
I'm staying away from you guys. I don't like the silt you're doing. It's a little little worrisome.
Here's $4.
Uh-oh.
We're coming for you.
Four forest bucks.
Oh,
Four forest bucks. Look at that.
Well, okay. Well, I'm switching gears, and I'm coming over to the lake.
Are you?
For free!
That's pretty good. That is pretty good. I am going to... that could be pretty fun, actually. But I don't like the idea of that, and I have to pull that back. So, okay. I am going to take one of these wild dice, and I am going to place it on the hills for one coin.
Ooh.
Take that. Shocker, shocker.
Fascinating.
Isn't it? The hills are alive.
Hey, alive they are. I have a little bit of money left. Let's see here.
What could go wrong? I mean, really.
I'm going to pay one. Am I going to do that?
I don't know.
How much money do you guys have left? Yeah, now it gets interesting, doesn't
it? Yeah, it does.
I really kind of want to join.
That hills action, don't you?
I kind of want to get in on that hills action. I'm not going to lie. All right, we're going to go ahead and we're going to use one of my workers to get $3 back.
Ooh, planning ahead.
Mm.
Hey, Charlie, go get me some cash.
That's right.
All right.
What more work?
Boy, you're making me change my plans on a dime here. I'm going to spend three and put this guy right up here.
You spend a lot of time writing these down, don't you, Chaz?
That one wasn't even on purpose, if there was one.
Nice. Very nice. I am going to... I am going to open up the mountains for zero. Take that, gentlemen.
That was unexpected.
So, I almost did that last turn. I was really considering it, but...
It poses an interesting question now, because you have a lot of money and at least a worker left.
Yeah. I'm going to spend $1.
Mm-hmm.
$1, Bob.
We're going to go to the lake. Sure.
Oh, the lake.
It's very wonderful this time of year. The waters are warm. Scenery is bright.
Sorry about that. I can't decide between the hills and the lake, but all things considered, come here, little guy. I think I'm going lakeward. There you go.
Well, that works for me. I am going to send one of my guys over to the mountains. For free.
Yep.
Seems like a good call.
All right. I'm going to use $4 and send a worker to the hills.
Get him going in spot number four. Darn it. I was hoping that you only had three money left. But...
That's my evil prospector laugh. That's good. Twirling my mustache as well.
And I'm out of meeples.
Are you now? So yes. You're passing.
Okay.
Well, that's very interesting then. I have a solid choice as to what I want to do here. I could either make that a two, make that. I'm going to spend all four of my remaining coins that I have because I'm loaded. And
oh, we know he has $7.
Place a minor Jerry over on the river.
Wow, that river. That river.
River runs through it.
All right, so I'm also passing, so I'm going to take everything that is outside of my player screen and return it to behind my player screen.
Yep. Chaz passed last turn, so he gets his money back. And then technically it would come to me, and technically I would pass at this point, so I would then remove all of my money from public view and put it back on my screen as well.
Yep.
Therefore, gentlemen, it is now time to go mining.
It is mining time. Okay, so let's get started at the hills. We have four prospectors, and we have two dice. We're going to be turning eight cards from the hills.
That sounds good.
Here we go.
We have four prospectors there?
Yes. Two reds, a blue, and a yellow.
Oh, I am not seeing anybody on spot number one. Sorry.
On spot number one?
Yeah. Oh, there he is. Hi.
There you go.
Tabletopia kind of bugs on visibility sometimes, it looks like. All right, next card. We got a three gold.
Three gold, that's good.
Next card. Oh, there's a one. That's good.
All right.
There's some silt.
Some silt, that's not three. Too good.
How many are we doing? We're doing eight cards. Another three. A lot of money to be had in the hills today. Five.
Look at this.
Six.
Look at that.
Seven. And a false alarm.
Uh-oh.
Okay. So, we're going to collect everything.
Oh,
we're going to resolve our false alarm.
Garnet, don't go away. Stay in the hill.
Put it on the bottom of the deck.
There it goes.
And let's see what our remaining seven are.
All the garnet.
There you go.
So I have first pick because I have the majority. I am going to pull one of my guys off, put him on my player screen, and I will take the garnet.
Okay. We now have a tied majority, and I am next.
That is
so that's up there. So I kind of want one of these threes. I'm pretty okay with that. So I'm going to do that and return my worker to my player screen.
Okay. Now,
at this point, Chaz, why don't you go ahead and pick yours, and then I'll make my comment.
Okay, I'm going to try and offset some of those river nuggets I got, so I'll take that one.
The river nuggets. I am going to take my guy back, and I'm going to take the two.
Yeah. Seems reasonable.
Seems reasonable, yeah. So you may be asking yourself at this point, why are they not just going after all the money? And we talked a little bit about that earlier, that you're going to have to give up the set of gold that you have mined the most of, because that's your fool's gold. So one of the interesting balances in this game is not necessarily hoarding all the gold from all the locations, because you could end up losing, you know, you will end up losing your highest location. So fives are real nice and fours are real nice, but sometimes you get a little bit more ahead by mining the threes and the twos.
Yep. Okay. So we are on to the forest, and this is our first foray into the forest.
Look at you, cards. Learning from the master.
That wasn't so much a pun, just alliteration.
Yeah.
All right, eight cards. We have some forest silt.
Ooh.
We have...
Ooh, the topaz. Nice.
We have a gold nugget. More gold nuggets.
You have gold. Isn't that weird?
Foul weather is card number seven, which means we draw one less and we do not get our eighth and final card.
Thankfully, there's no false alarm.
No false alarms. So we have this to work with. So I have a tied majority with Chaz, but I am further up the road. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to collect the topaz into my hand.
All right.
I love games when you make a decision and somebody else goes.
Okay, I'll grab that four.
Ooh.
Because I am greedy.
Hey, I mean, there's no complaints about that.
I'm going to take the two and remove that worker. And would you like to brave the winter, Mr. Chaz? Or do you want to just take $2?
Do I want $2 or brave the winter? Hmm. Let me look. Forest is the second lowest in terms of the chart we have of how high the nuggets go.
Four is the highest amount of gold nuggets you'll get.
So you know what I'm going to do is I think I'm going to take my guy and my $2.
Seems good.
Okay. All right. And that wraps up the forest. So we will collect these cards, throw them back in the deck, give it a shuffle, the dice, and on to the mountains we go. The mountains, we just have one prospector.
Yep,
Scott made his way up there.
Really good or really bad?
you get one card, one prospector, one dice. You know what? You're going to pick it yourself.
Go ahead. Okay. Survey says... Hey!
Four gold!
I'll take that all day long and put it in my hand and go ahead and bring Minor Mary, I think, back over from the mountains because that's alliteration. Now I get my big dog.
All right, we're going to reshuffle the mountains.
Yep.
Okay, now we have this one. Yes, you have two of your own workers there with four dice, so we're doing eight cards that Scott's going to get to pick from. All right, we have a single nugget. We have a gem.
I like that. A double nugget.
Some silt.
Oh, more silt.
Six.
Uh-oh.
Seven, and eighth card is silt. Okay. Oh,
we're that's only seven all this cards. And you can't count.
Three, four, five, six, seven. Oh, no, no.
Gotta watch these guys. I'm crazy. Gotta watch these guys. All
right, there we go. All right.
All right, so I feel a little better with that. Okay, all right.
All right.
Give me my false alarm here. This is the Benatoit, I think is how you say it. I'm not a gem expert, so I apologize if I slaughter that French-sounding term.
A gemologist?
I'm not a gemologist.
All right, no. Give it a little shuffle.
Survey
says... Dump one of these on the bottom of the deck, and we have...
Yeah!
There you go. All right. Lost a little bit of gold. But,
okay, so my first guy I will pick up, return, and take the gem. And my second guy I will pick up and return and take the two.
All right.
So I will put both of my miners, Bob and Ben, back onto my board. You'll shuffle up the river, and we'll return
all
the
dice. You want to go ahead and return the dice, and I'll start, and you can get the lake.
Yep.
All right, so, Chaz, you and I doing the lake. We have three workers, one die. Going to be three cards to pick from. We have three nuggets. Oh, and a foul weather. So only two cards. From which is not good for me because Chaz, you have the majority. Would you like the three or would you like to, hang out for winter?
Let me grab one of my coins to flip. No, I will take that.
Figured I'd, give you the option. All right, so you take one of your guys back. All right, so now I have the option of taking money or sticking around for winter. And frankly, I'm going to wait it out. We're going to lay down for winter.
Okay.
I am also
okay.
Hold out for winter.
All right. So this foul weather goes to the bottom. I go ahead and roll the weather or the winter die.
Mm-hmm.
And we get four cards.
Four. Nice. That could have been disastrous if it was only one.
Silt. A five.
Ooh, look at that.
Silt. And a gem.
Wow. You guys had a good winter.
That makes me kind of happy. Wow, that was a good winter. All right, so as the person higher up on the road, I'm going to go ahead and pull him back, stand him up behind my player screen, and collect that gem.
Seems good. Chaz, are you going for the Cinco, or are you going to get some money back?
Oh, boy. Let me see here. You know what? Again, greedy, so I'll take that fiver.
At the end of the day, more gold is more points. Even if you end up losing the most valuable one, as long as you can kind of disperse it between the number of decks you have, you can manage yourself pretty well, actually.
Yeah,
so. That's true. That's one of the things I love about this game is just the way that you can mitigate it across the different piles. And after a while, you can kind of catch up and not lose as much.
All right.
All right.
You are now the first player, Mr. Passport.
In your next
Ryan.
Year, another worker and another dollar.
Each get our workers, each get a dollar. I'll buy that for a dollar. I have a lot of money now. I mean, no, I don't. Don't pay attention.
I've got like why would I 30 say gold back here. You don't even know what I've got.
30 gold. Yeah, don't be sneaking one. It's not one for you, one for me, two for you, one, two for me, right?
All right. I'm going to roll the prospecting dice to get us started in our next year here. I'm going to roll a bunch of times.
What does 1851 bring us?
There we go.
It's a disco ball of rolling dice.
All right. So we got a whole bunch of ones.
Man. Those hills are interesting. Okay.
And we got 1-5. So we got something everywhere, and we got two wilds.
One of my favorite subtleties about this game, and I'm just going to point it out here right now real quick because I have a couple of gems in my possession. If you look at how the board is laid out with the hills going all the way around to the lake, the gem that you're trying to collect from each one on the card has a little pentagon in the upper left, and the highlighted space is their highlighted space that they position on the board. So, like, for example, the purple one is the lower right of the pentagon, and on the board, looking at it proper, is the lower right of the board. I've just always liked little graphic design stuff like that can be done with games.
Yeah, it's very cool. Okay, so where are we going?
Well, I don't know. Where are we going?
Where is Ryan going next
on Passport Games?
I'm going to send a worker to the lake.
The Lake.
Good enough. I had a lot of good luck there, and I want to go back to the lake.
The Lake. That seems pretty good. I am going to let Chaz go before I do anything.
Well, I got my three monies, and that's going to buy me this spot in this slot.
Going for the hills. I'm cheap.
Hey.
I'm really cheap. I am going to go to the forest for zero. My guys are efficient. They don't spend a lot of money.
I'm going to spend
supplies and pith helmets and axes and all that fun stuff.
$1 and send another of my workers to
the lake. Ryan really likes the lake.
All right. We are going to go to the mountains because we did so well when we went there last time.
Mountain. The mountains were kind of... I was happy with the mountains last time. So
yeah. Okay.
They worked out all right. Okay. I am... You know what? Chaz, I'm going to join you at the mountains for one.
More the better.
One there and one gold. There we go.
I'm going to spend one gold, and I'm going to take one of these wild dice and add it to the lake.
Yeah, good move.
Oh, my. Well, we can't let that get out of hand. So I'm going to spend one gold.
And put it on the mountain.
Taking this dice. Yeah, I'm sending it over to the mountains.
Yeah, I like that.
There you
like
go.
That.
There you go.
Because then I can spend one, and I can put a guy over in the forest for cheap. Which works for me.
Yeah. Let's see here. Where do I want to go next?
Where do you want to go next? Where does Ryan want to go next?
Want to go to the river.
To the river. In a world where the river runs.
With blood.
That kind of game.
Sorry.
That's a different kind of game, a different kind of movie. That's like Fury of Dracula business.
Really?
Right there.
Fool's gold of death. Oh, what is that? Hey, Mr. Mountain.
Paid a bunch
man.
Of money.
Wow.
How much did you pay for that?
Three Me? Gold.
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't like that at all. So I will pay. I'm gonna like snipe you here. I'm
snipe.
Gonna pay five and go there. One, two, three, four, five, three. Four,
oh, it's awesome.
And five.
Intense.
Is it on? Is it on like Donkey Kong? You never know.
Well, we're prospectors, so it's more of a, you know, mule pack.
That is true. That is true.
All right. I'll pay $1 and I'm going to send the prospector to the river again.
Boy, we are just giving Ryan the water areas for so cheap.
Yes.
I'm going to dominate the water temple.
Yeah.
Wait, again, wrong game.
Aquaman.
Aquaman, that's right.
Oops. Lego. I got too many things here. I'm gonna pay four if I can grab four here. So there we go.
Money bags over here, man.
Yeah, really.
Cha-ching. And I'll take slot number four, even though you were trying to snipe me.
Oh, okay. Didn't know if you were gonna blow the money or not. So, all right.
Yeah.
That's okay. That's fair. I'll take that. I am going to send Minor Mary to get me three coins.
Uh-oh. Clever girl.
Clever girl. He had fool's gold. We spared no expense.
I'll spend two, and I'm going to visit the river again.
Yeah, seems good. Hey, if we're not fighting you over it, why worry about it, right?
Yeah.
Minor guy here is going to give me three gold back.
Yeah, is he French? Minor Guy?
Miner.
I am going to spend the remaining six gold that I have.
Oh, man.
And I would like to visit the mountains.
Look at that. That is going to be many a card.
Wow. That's going to be a lot of cards.
You guys are crazy.
Yeah, that's kind of crazy, right? It's not, I mean, it's no, bad. It's no river. Want to be good at
mountains. You might say we have gold fever.
We might.
Gold fever. All right, here's $3. And I will send a worker to the lake.
Crepe in a pipe. Very good.
There you go.
All right.
Do you have anybody left, Chaz, or are you passing?
I got one guy left.
Oh, do you?
And he's going to the mountains just to give me priority there.
I was worried you had one guy left. Yep, there you go.
Okay.
I'm going to pass, so I'm going to take all my piles of Scrooge McDuck money back here and take Minor Mary back since she did so well getting me my coins.
And all right.
We're off to the mining phase.
Okay, Chaz, you get your choice of four cards from the hills. You have a garnet, a false alarm, another garnet, I think you're okay there, and some silt.
Pretty good.
So, let's go ahead and resolve that false alarm for...
I think the worst thing that can happen here is Thoreau's sake. One of the two cards that you want to get.
Right. There you go.
Well, dosh garnet, I'll take the garnet.
If I must. That seems like a pretty safe bet for 3 gold.
Yeah.
All right. The forest. We have 2 cards for Scott.
Yes, we do.
There's a 3 nugget. And there's a topaz.
Nice. I will
good, man.
Be pulling both my guys back, and Bob and Ben will get me the 3 gold and a beautiful, beautiful gem.
Wow.
Good job, right. Guys. Good job. That's how you go mining.
We're going to have quite the showdown at
the
mountains.
We have a
here.
Major miner in the mountains right now.
4, 6 times 2, 12 cards are getting turned out of the mountains here.
Yep. Oh, yeah.
All right. 1.
It's going to be like 12 silt.
2. 3.
I like these odds. Come on.
4.
Oh, my.
5.
Wow. Yep.
6.
You knew that was this coming. Is... Uh-oh.
7.
Oh, my goodness.
8. All right. 9. We're getting better. Yeah.
These mountains are broken.
Okay. All right. We're good. Oh, 11. That's not good at all.
And a foul weather that doesn't hit us at all.
Foul weather at the end is not bad. Actually, foul weather at the end is kind of good because it gives you a card that you can lose and not worry about. So.
All right. So we got to do
Man, that's a lot of false alarms.
Oh, man.
I'm not feeling good about this, Chaz. I don't know about you.
We're losing 3 of these.
I have a minor issue with this.
3 cards going to the bottom. Right. Remaining 9 are as follows.
Hmm.
All right.
Okay.
So my sneaky move there at the end gave me majority.
You got the majority. You got 4 guys there.
So I'll grab him and this 3.
That seems good. I am. Going to now as a good point of reflection here, can we pull anyone up, or does it have to be the guy furthest up the track?
Has to be furthest up the track.
That is correct. Yeah. Yes. Okay. So, I am going to actually, I'm going to lay down my guy for winter.
Ooh.
I'm going to take a little bit of a risk here. Now, because I've laid him down, I still have the majority. So. I get to take the next action, correct?
Oh, that is a good question.
Yeah.
I believe that is correct.
Yeah, it is logical. It is cunning and makes me angry.
All right, so I'm going to pull Ben back, and I'm going to take a 2.
Yeah, that was a really good play with the... Okay, I will grab the other 2 and pull my other guy back.
Seems good. I am going to pull back my guy and get 2 gold.
Oh, all right. And my last prospector is going to wait for winter as well.
There you go. All right. What could winter now, hold?
Now, do I, now with my guy at standing by the deck the, with the winter cards, does that mean I still have majority now and I'll get first pick of those?
I believe that is correct.
Yeah. Yeah, but the reserve characters still count towards your majority.
Yeah, they don't go away until the end of winter. So you technically are going to get the first card. You want me to roll the winter die?
Yep. Roll the winter die. You're the highest up the path there.
We'll roll the winter die. Whoops, hang on. I put it on a one. I didn't roll it. Hang on. There we go. There we go. I put it on the one. Ba-boom.
And we get a two.
Ooh.
No. Whew.
Nope. I'm going to get nothing.
I will take that action.
Taking the
silt. So you, Scott, can pull your guy back for money.
I will do that. I will take my guy back and get two coins.
We'll wrap up the mountain there, give it a shuffle. Send the dice back to the middle.
Wait, the during the winter, you can't take your guys back for two gold.
Oh, that's right, you can't. Yes.
Excuse me. You're correct. Absolutely right.
Kind of screwed up the deck here. Hang on. I'm going to fix that. Hang on.
I got it.
You got it? Okay. There's coins on the bottom is the problem. Yeah, there you go. All right. So I didn't take those coins. They're still there. So that's good. You're right, Chaz, because winter is brutal and harsh, and winter is coming.
You had me until that last.
I don't even know what it means, but okay.
All right.
I don't watch Lord of the Rings. No. People can't see it right now, but Ryan is fuming at me.
You monster. All right. So we have three of my workers or three cards from the river. There's some silts and foul weather.
Oh, no.
I don't get anything during the river.
Think about all the money you could get, though.
I could just pull them back for a bunch of money.
Yeah, because technically that's the cards that come out. You could get six gold, or you could leave them all out for winter.
All right, first one I'm going to pull back for money.
Seems good.
I'm going to take $2, put them back here behind my screen. These two I'm going to go ahead and lay down for winter, though. Better results in the winter.
Better results in the winter is a good thing.
All right, so we're going to roll the die, and we get a two. I got silt. Oh my goodness! I put the cards on the bottom even.
I know, that's terrible. Well, you are consistent at the river, sir.
I'm sorry.
I got nothing from the river that time. Nothing from the river.
She's a harsh mistress.
Yeah, no kidding. Give that a shuffle, turn the die.
Or a harsh mister, I guess, depending on your perspective.
All right.
Will the lake be better to you is the question.
Six cards from the lake. Nice.
Seems good so far. Apparently you were too far upstream.
Four. Five.
Look at that. Look at that.
That is a thing. All right. So here's the deal.
Money bags Ryan over here now.
The workers. What do I want? The first one I'm going to take and I'm going to get $2.
Mm-hmm.
The second one, we're going to take, and we're going to get these beads. And then I will take with the last one. Decisions. If viewers at home are wondering why I'm not snap picking the tourmaline, it's because I already have one, and you can only have one of each gem. So, with my last worker, I think I'm just going to get $2 again.
Very good.
Alright, so, we are all done with our third year. These all go back to the lake. We reshuffle. Turn the dice.
End of the year. We're now on to 1852. Which, if anybody has a bottle of wine from then, you have more money than I do.
Chaz, you can go ahead and take your...
Chaz! You get the pickaxe.
Okay, before we get into the second to the last round here, I had a question about the final scoring. We know that we're going to discard the cards from the mine where we have the most nuggets.
Correct.
But what if we have a tie in our hand? Do we discard just one of those two, or do we have to discard all of them that tie for the most?
That's a great question. Let me consult the book and double check here.
Okay, and while you do that, I will roll the bones.
Yeah, you go ahead and start allocating for prospecting phase here.
Fired up.
Whoa,
they're all over the place.
All over the place. Wild dice.
A lot of wild dice.
There we go. Okay, there we go.
Let's see here.
Oh, I see. You're just going to reroll until you get the numbers you want. That's the way
it is. Oh, no. They kind of froze on my screen, so I thought they were.
Sure. Froze. Dr. Evil air quotes froze. Yeah. These dice froze. Isn't that weird? I love food.
I could understand.
Oh, that was a 5.
Add a total value of each group. Gold cards, count the number of nuggets.
That was a 5. Okay. That was a 5. Okay. The one you're holding was a 5. Yes.
Yeah, I was actually trying to tip it over, but I couldn't quite get it.
There we go.
Oh, you did it. It was sweet.
So, the text in the book states, the location that gives you the highest total is Fool's Gold. You must discard those cards. For all of the other gold cards you have, you receive 1 point for each nugget. It does not specify what happens in the case of a tie on highest number of nuggets.
I believe in a tie for highest number of nuggets, you get to choose because mathematically it would not make a difference.
Okay. Yeah. All right. Just wanted to make sure that it was figured out before we got to that point in scoring. So we kind of plan.
I mean, Ryan's going to win, but it's okay. We actually, as people are patiently watching us and playing through this, we actually script all this so that Ryan wins every time. He's really not better than us. So.
Wow, that's harsh. Credit.
Your Simmer comeback was huge. If anyone hasn't seen that, highly recommend you go check that out because it was almost like a 13 or 14 point swing at the end of the game. So,
yeah.
Chaz, what do you got here, man? That's a lot of money. What are you doing?
I'm grabbing the entire table and moving it instead of my one meeple who's going to the hills.
That's okay. All right.
Hills.
I am going to send Mary to the mountains again.
Yeah.
I like that idea. Whoops. Get on the mountains, Mary. Come on. There you go. All right. I like those cheap spots. Efficient workers. That's the way we roll.
I'm going to spend $6. And I'm going to join you in the mountains.
What?
Whoa. Crazy.
Wow.
How do you like them apples?
Man, Pele the miner just ran by me doing 100 miles an hour going, see you later, Barry. Wow. That's crazy. That's just crazy talk, man. That's like something like Jake or Elwood would do. Okay. Whoa. Going to the hills. Well. I am going to spend one coin, and I am going to go to the mountains. So take that, Mr. Six Coins.
I'm going to spend two coins.
And also go to the mountains.
No, I'm not going to do that, actually. I'm just kidding. We're going to spend no coins, and we're going to open up the river with that wild die.
Seems pretty good.
Oh, that is wild.
Seems wild. We're crazy. Crazy in the river.
Well, I'm going to cross that bridge.
Go right there. Okay.
Seems good. Where am I going to go? You know what? I am going to join you, Chaz. I'm going to spend one, and I am also going to go to the river. Seems like
good. Hope you brought your flip-flops.
I always do, wherever I go.
Good.
I will spend $2 and come to the river.
Whoa, okay. See, that $6 was just a giant head fake because he had like 400 gold.
Yeah.
Indeed. All right, well, this is getting expensive now. So let's move 3 more gold and let's also hit the river.
Wow. The river is suddenly running. I am going to spend $1, and I am going to go to the forest.
I will spend $2 once again. And I will return. Whoops, if I can click my worker properly. And I will send him to the mountains.
Seems good.
Okay.
I'm going to build a little Corellian Corvette out of my coins here.
Wow, the alliteration.
Going over to the forest.
Are you now?
Hmm. Yep, Minor Gump is going to go over to the forest. Minor Gump.
Ah, that's beautiful. I am going to spend 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And I am going to go to the river. Take that.
Wow. You guys are really...
Yes?
Forcing my hand here.
That's the idea.
I'm going to spend 4.
Uh-huh.
We're going to come to the river.
Yep.
Wowzers.
It's a raging river right now. Which is, you know, in 1852, the way most things were. So, as documented erroneously on the internet.
I'm going to spend 1 and just put my wee little worker down by the lake.
Yeah, wee worker at the lake. There always have to be lucky lakes.
Oh, darn it. That was the one place I didn't want to go. But I saw it was cheap, and I lost focus.
Nice. Well done, sir. Well done.
My miner saw something shiny. I got distracted, apparently.
Is that what it is? I'm going to spend 3. Uno, okay. Dos, tres. And I am going to go to the forest.
I am tempting to join you in the forest, but I think I'm going to pass.
Are you?
And I'm going to send my remaining workers to here and to here.
That seems like a good play. Seems good.
And then I'm going to pick up all my money and put it back between you all and my screen.
Cool.
Maybe. That was a fail.
All right. Chaz, are you passing?
Yeah, I'm at the point where I have to pass. So I got one worker that I got to put somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
And, oh, come here. Come here, little guy. The only place it makes sense to put him would be the river or the forest. But with Ryan's big play there, it doesn't really even make sense to put him at the forest.
yeah, unless I could. 6 cards in the forest and you'll get the second pick.
I'll get the second pick anyway.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, if I put him over here, that gives me 3. That's supposed to be ahead of you, and sometimes that's all that matters.
Okay. Sometimes it is. I, too, am going to pass, and I am going to put my guy at the river.
No, I forgot you still exist. Ah. This is a bad round. Bad round.
Oh, man.
All my good time. Duck money comes back. And... let's go to the hills.
All right. Are we ready? Ready to do some mining?
Yeah.
Looks like we're going to get 8 cards for Chaz in the hills.
Oh, yeah.
All right. Let's do it. There's some silk
nothing
for you.
Nothing can go wrong now.
There's a false alarm. There's some more silk for you.
These aren't the cards.
There's some foul weather. That's too bad for you.
I've seen
so we're now going down to 7 cards, so 3 more.
This is not looking good, Chaz.
5, 6, and last card is a single nugget.
Yikes.
Beef. All right. So we need to lose one, right?
Oh, yes. And we need to resolve that false alarm.
No, that's not good.
Take all these.
I'm crossing my fingers for you, Chaz. I'm pulling for you.
Shuffle them up a little bit. It's not finger icy. 1 card goes to the bottom. And our final 6 is... there you go.
Hey, there you go.
Sweet.
So there you go.
I pick you, and I pick you.
I choose you, Gold Nuggets.
All right, these will go back to the hills with a shuffle.
That seems pretty good. I will get the dice for you.
Okay, I will start up on the forest. We have a total of 3 times 2 for 6 cards.
Yeah.
Chaz and Scott. We have a false alarm.
Oh, come on.
Foul weather, bringing us down to 5.
Man, what a way to start this off. Some silt just for
it
the...
It just keeps getting worse.
Another silt in the wounds.
And silt. So, do we bother resolving 2 false alarms?
Negative.
So, yeah, why don't you guys go ahead and decide whether you're going to pull back for money or lay down for winter.
I'm going to lay my first guy down for winter, and I'm going to lay my second guy down for winter. Chaz, what would you like to do?
Let's see, you're getting first dibs. I'll lay down for winter. I have a good feeling about winter.
All right. Oops. Scott, roll that winter die. Let's see how many cards you're going to get.
Survey says...
4 cards.
4 cards. That's a good roll. And silt. 4 silt. Here it comes.
There's a nugget. There's a double nugget.
Nice.
And another double nugget.
Nice.
Not bad. Not a bad winter, guys. Not a bad winter.
My first guy will come back to me, and I will get a 2.
Okay.
I will take not only a double nugget, but you just gave me the name of the next pet that I own. Double nugget.
Double nugget. Okay. And then Scott, I will pull my last guy back and get the 1.
All right.
Seems good, gents. Seems good.
Shuffle up the forest. Okay, so... We have a total of 4 cards coming out of the mountains, and I will have first pick with both a majority and the lead on the path.
Yes.
So, yes. There's a 3 nugget. There's a 2 nugget.
Oof.
There's a 4 nugget. Mm-hmm. And some foul weather. But that's okay.
That is okay.
Okay with me. So we pull this little gentleman back, and we get 4 gold nuggets.
Seems good.
I've had worse decisions.
I am going to pull my guy back.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm actually going to take the 2.
All right. I'll pull back and take the 3.
Nice. And then I will lay down for winter. All right, we ready? You want to put the card on the bottom there, and I'll roll the die for winner?
Yep. To the bottom it goes.
3 cards.
3 cards. Silt. And foul weather.
It's a harsh.
This is the winter.
Harsh. Harsh. Man, it's like being in No Country for Old Men. It's just...
Shuffle the mountains, my reserve back.
We are off to the river. Come on, this has got to be good.
All right. Give me a big one. How many do we have here? 3, 4, 5, 6 cards?
Yep.
All right. False alarm.
I get the first pick.
Silt. More silt.
Of a lot of crud.
4. 5.
Hey!
And we resolve our false alarm.
All right. Watch the
false alarm. By sending the 5 nuggets away.
Yep. Here
at the bottom.
Here it comes.
Let's see here.
Give it a shuffle. Coming a mile away.
Oops. I drew a card. Let me put that back.
Don't draw a card. Don't cheat.
Shuffle.
Survey
card
says.
To the bottom.
There. Bye-bye, 5 nuggets.
Oh, right. Nice. So I have 4 guys to Scott's 3. So I have first pick.
You have 3 guys.
I have 4 guys.
Where's your 4th? Oh, he was hidden. I didn't even see him. Tabletopia. Oh, Tabletopia.
I was like, I'm not sure how he thinks he's getting first
pick
here.
Yeah, I only showed one of your guys there. When you were placing them out, it didn't show one of your guys for some reason. So
I gotcha.
Technological.
I apologize for that. But yeah, so I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to pull my first guy back and take the 5 nugget.
Seems good. I'm going to lay my guy down for winter. And if anyone's curious how we do that, in Tabletopia, you just hit the F key and it will flip your meeple down. It's actually something that was programmed into this one specifically to lay them down.
Oh, it was specific to this one?
Yeah, normally the F key flips over something, but in this case, we set it up for the meeples. It interacts to where it just lays them down.
Okay. This guy's going to wait for winter as well.
Oh, boy. We're going to roll a 1.
All right.
I can see.
Yeah, I will also be waiting for winter.
I'm going to pull my guy back for 2 coins.
Okay.
Because I'm not sticking around for that harsh of a winter.
And this guy's also going coinward.
All right. Scott, you are furthest up the track with our winter weather faring
thank goodness. When we roll a one,
then these help me out.
All right, survey says three again. All right, I'm pretty consistent with that.
Silt and silt. For me, more silt and
So I get nothing because I already have a gem from the river. So my guy comes back and says, boo-hoo, it's so lame that I can only get one gem.
Yes, you also have one of those, right? Please?
Yeah, I do.
Ah, I can't take it.
It's all yours.
That works out well. Boy, did that work out well.
Wow. That
winter is a harsh season.
Luck ball.
Harsh
quite season. The luck ball for me. All right, back to my reserves and do the final lake.
Yep.
What do you got here? You got a bunch of guys, but just two cards.
One.
There's some silt.
And there's a five spotter.
Ooh. Darn.
Cards back.
I'm going.
It's a little painful because that might screw up which one you have to get rid of, right?
I'm going to wait for winter.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. You've had a lot of lake cards in the past there, buddy.
So these are going to hit the bottom of the deck.
So you may be asking yourself again, why would Chaz do this? Well, that five could push him over the limit where he has to discard his lake, which is not good.
Yep.
All right, sorry. Where's that winter dice?
It would be the white die that looks like winter.
Yes. Sorry.
It's at the top.
I was sitting there.
Mountains.
And. Oops.
Mouse over.
There it is. Yeah.
Two card.
Seems good.
There's a single gold nugget.
That's good.
And some foul weather. Hey there. So, would you like the gold nugget or nothing?
You could match your tooth. Solid. All right. We're on to 1853, gentlemen.
Take your final dollar and your final prospector.
Buck, final guy, final round. It's all down to this. I feel pretty good going into this. I get the first player pickaxe.
Yes.
Which I'm quite happy with. I'm going to turn that 180 degrees just because I can and I want to keep consistency. We're going to roll the bones, gentlemen, and see what we get. You ready?
Let's do it.
Ah, look at that.
All right.
No. Zero. Zip. Zilch. Wild dice.
All righty.
That's going to
work
be
with what we got.
Fun final year. All righty. Lots of threes. Lots of twos. All right. Ah, Chaz, you are not allowed to interface.
Right. Drop it. Drop it. Good.
There you go. Okay.
Does this four need to go over there? Is this in the wrong spot?
Nope, that four is right where it needs to be.
It's in the right spot. Oh. Yep, the river is the four.
So I was still in the center circle for me.
Okay. Well,
check the tape.
You get for the Eugene, Oregon internet. All right, I'm going to spend one, go to the mountains. Again, efficiency.
Let's see. Where do I want to go? I feel like I need
not
to
only
spend
is there no wild ball. Dice, it's like extremely balanced. Apart from a one for a five, that was about as
We're
average as
forest.
I could get. Man. Just like any other dice game, I roll for average.
I'm gonna give two coins to
I have a good friend of mine who, whenever he rolls dice, has a very high propensity to roll sixes, and he calls it risk style. Look at that. Okay, I see where you're going. I am going to go over to the hills for zero. Again, efficiency.
Okay. I think I want more of this forest action. We're going to spend three. Send another gentleman right there.
Seems good.
Okay. Just one moment while I count out.
I have this fat stack of cash over here.
I. 6.
7, 49. Divide by pi. Add 0. Uh-oh, look at that. Take that, Forest Ranger. I'm going to spend
what?
two and go to the mountains. Since you guys are fighting in the forest.
Go to the mountains, huh?
Yeah, seems cheap and good.
Huh.
Can't imagine what I'm going for there, but I'm sure
interesting.
You can figure it out. The viewers at home know.
I'll pay two
mm-hmm.
and send a gentleman to the hills.
Ooh, look at you skipping along in the hills. Seems good. That seems good. Okay, Jazz, where are you going?
Can't get enough of those oak trees, so I'm going to go back to the forest.
Oh, now. My God, Chaz.
You guys are all over this. My goodness.
What's the matter with you?
I am going to spend three. One, two, three, and go to the mountains. I'm digging deep.
Dig deep.
I have to. Have you been shuffling the mountain deck?
Yeah. Or for the mountains.
There you go.
Oh, boo.
Anger management with Chaz. Oh,
boo. I'm going to ditch a prospector and get three gold back.
Yeah, okay. Well, that move makes me angry. I see no reason not to do this, so I will spend one, and I will go to the river.
Go to the river, yeah.
Cheap is good.
I'm going to spend five.
Go to the mountains.
Go to the forest.
Go to the forest. Look at that.
All right.
Sneaky, sneaky miner. I like how you guys have patterned that out. One of mine, one of yours, one of yours.
Let's spend. Oh, man.
Oh, no.
Nope. I'm spending two, and I'm going back to that lake.
Oh, even though, there you go. I like that idea. Come help me out there.
No, I shouldn't.
No. Oh, lake. I'm sorry. I thought you said river. Yeah, lake. Okay.
All right. This is Scott's turn. Right.
What do I want to do? What do I want to do? I am going to go to the hills for one.
Okay.
Take that.
I will spend a worker and get $3 back.
Seems good. Mister, I'm going to go to the mountains for $6.
I'm going to spend three. Send this guy over to the lake as well.
Oh. Digging deep underwater, are we?
He can hold his breath really well.
Seems
that's
good.
Minor Cousteau.
Cousteau, not Zissou.
Gesundheit.
Nobody gets that. Okay, I'm the only one that watched that movie. I think I might be, other than Wes Anderson.
I know the movie. I just haven't watched it.
It's great. I love it. We actually watch that movie every time we play Aquasphere. So,
what movie is it? Oh, is it the Michael Murray?
Aquatic with Steve Zissou.
it just hit Netflix, I saw.
Oh, that's good. That's really good. What, man, I'm kind of torn here on what I want to do because I have a couple of really good options.
That must be a nice feeling.
I'm going to spend five and go to the mountains.
Wow. You really are after something there. Must be looking for the last gem for a set or something.
Maybe.
Well, I can't beat your majority there now, so I don't think it's worth trying to go there.
If anybody doesn't know, I have a huge affinity to Wes Anderson movies. I very much enjoy his movies.
Yeah. I'm going to spend $4, and I'm going to go over here with Chaz on the lake.
That was my little lake party. I was thinking about, a little boat party.
Cooler by the lake. Well, since I don't trust Ryan at all. actually.
Here at Passport, we build teams based on trust.
So I'm going to take these two. Come here, little coins. And I'm going to. The river.
Good. Thank you. Help me out with some more cards. I like that idea. What do I want to do? I am going to spend my final three coins. Two and three. And I am going to go to the river.
Ooh.
Ta-dum.
All right.
Are you passing, Ryan?
I am passing, and I have a worker left. Uh-huh. I'm going to go ahead and send to the lake.
Oh, I thought you were going to go to the forest. Okay.
Nope.
Seems good.
Interesting.
Seems good. So Chaz?
Interesting place to put him. I also am going to pass, and I'm going to use this guy over at the forest.
I am passing, but I have nobody to place. So,
okay.
Off to the hills we go.
To the hills. All right, I'm going to pick up all my junk here first.
Three cards at the hills seems good. My camera's kind of whacking out on me. There we go. All right, there we go.
All right, three cards from the hills. We have false alarm.
False
alarm. And some silt.
I think we're just laying down for winter here, possibly.
You've got first pick, so you want gold, or do you want to wait for winter?
Gold is worth nothing at the end of the game, is that correct?
I believe. You think it might be a tiebreaker?
I think it's a tiebreaker, yeah, I think that's correct. I am going to lay down my guy for winter.
Actually, I don't even think it's a tiebreaker.
And then now, the next highest card values are your tiebreaker.
Yeah, so gold is not going to do you any good. So,
I'll lay both my guys down for winter.
I will do the same. So we'll take these cards, put them on the bottom of the hills.
I'm going to roll the winter die.
And we will roll it as four, five. Oh, you're going to roll.
Three. Look at that. I am consistent at that.
Silt. One gold.
Six.
And a garnet.
Woo. I get first pick.
Yep.
I am going to pull one of my guys back. And unfortunately, I have a garnet, so I will take the one gold.
Tragedy.
Tragedy strikes.
Also pull my guy back.
And then Minor Ben will come back to me weeping, saying the winter was
harsh. The garnets. And we have finished the hills. All right. So the forest. We have 6 times 2, 12 cards.
Wow, that's a lot.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6, 7, effectively.
Wow.
8.
Wow. Uh-oh. Nine, man, this is not healthy. Oh!
10, 11. One more card.
False alarm, false alarm. Oh, there you go. Okay.
Go. All right, pretty healthy. Now we gotta do this false alarm business.
And you're only losing one, so not too shabby.
Yep, we're losing one.
That could have been really, really painful had more false alarms come out.
One of these goes to the bottom. And 9 cards remaining.
That was one of your foul weathers. Wow. That was pretty good.
There we go. All right, Chaz, you have a majority. You are first pick here.
All right. I'll pull my guy back, and I'll take this guy right here.
The topaz.
That's right there. Well, I will pull my guy back and take this 4 gold nuggets.
Seems good.
All right. Let me see here. Let me do some quick math.
Math is good.
I will pull this guy back, and I'll take this 3.
Okay. I will lay down for winter.
Might as well do the same.
Yep. All right.
Sounds good. I'll handle the cards if you want to handle the dice. Or yeah, that's fine. You can do that because you're faster.
All right, so I will roll the winter die. We're going to get 4 cards.
Wow, that's pretty good.
Silt. Foul weather.
That is a harsh winter. Painful winter.
Winter.
All right, I'm not saying anything here, Iron Forge, but you better produce.
All right, what do we got? 5 times 2, 10 cards out of the mountains.
I was like, give me some mining. Come on, give me some gems.
There's 1. There's 2.
Oh, there you go.
3.
Now you're producing.
4. 5.
Don't quite understand why all dwarves are always Scottish.
7.
This is looking healthy.
8. 9.
Not anymore.
10. All right. So we got to do 2 false alarms.
And anybody watching at home knows what I am praying for right now. Shuffle those bad boys up, man. Flip them over.
Give them a shuffle. 2 cards off the top are going to the bottom of the deck. And our remaining 8.
Hey! There you go. Look at that. All right.
And you are first pick.
I'm first pick. Minor Mary is going to come through. He's going to get me one of the quartz, which is really ironic.
Gotta love that quartz.
Love quartz. Love everything about quartz.
You have a majority still, so you pick.
I still do have the majority. I cannot take the quartz, so I am going to pull back Minor Bob, and I will take the 2.
Okay.
And then I will lay down both of my guys for winter.
Yep. And my guy is going to take me that quartz.
Sure. Seems good.
Seems very good.
I will go ahead and roll the die for winter. 2 cards. So those will go on the bottom.
You're going to get 2 cards. These go to the bottom. And 1 card is silt, and 2 cards is a quartz.
Okay. That does nothing for me. And just as a reminder, so everybody knows, you can't have more than 1 of each of the gems.
Yep. All right. 3 times 2 is 6 cards from the river.
Seems healthy.
4 chasms. Here we go. There's a bunch of gold.
Come on.
Foul weather counts as 2. Front 4. Ooh. 5. And.
Uh-oh.
False alarm.
Uh-oh. That's not good, Chaz.
I'm sorry.
He said.
Final 4 cards is. There you go. It worked out.
All right. I am going to pull my Minor Ben back to my board and take the 5.
Okay. My guy will take the 4.
Seems good.
Okay.
I'm going to lay down for winter.
Do a winter turn. You go to the bottom. Roll the die.
Survey says 3. I like that.
1, 2, 3 cards. Not bad. You're picking the litter, man.
I am going to take the 3.
Okay.
Because math.
Because math. All right, we have 3 times 3, 9 cards coming out of the lake for our final resolution. Silt, foul weather, gold, gem.
Ooh, look at that. Uh-oh.
7, 8.
That's not what I want to see.
Wow.
That is not brutal. Good.
That
is not good.
Let's see what happens with this false start here.
Uh-oh.
To the bottom we go. And final 7 are...
Ooh,
there you go.
One of the...
Majority is me, with me being on the... Or top of the tide, rather. And I'm top of the road, so I'm going to pull my one guy back. And actually, am I going to do that?
I don't know. Are you going to do that?
I'm going to lay him down for winter.
Oh, he's sweet.
Chaz is happy.
I'll take the false alarm. I'm going to take the Thermidor, whatever this thing is.
Tullamarine.
Precious, precious mineral resource.
And we called it tourmaline because amethyst is too hard to say. No.
Oh, and for my next one.
For my next trick.
I guess I'll lay. Oh, wait, actually, you know what? Let me do some little maths here. Sure, I'll take the 1.
Take the 1?
There you go.
Yeah.
All right.
Ryan's hunting. What's Ryan hunting for?
All right, we're going to flip. Or no, not flip. We're going to roll.
Roll.
Oh, 1
card.
Oh,
no. Watch it be a 5. Here it comes.
A 3.
Hey, that's healthy.
And I will take that 3. All right. And that is the final location of the final year of Fool's Gold.
That is.
So I would move into final scoring.
Yes. So now we have to reveal our hands. And I'm just going to stack my stuff in the order of what it is. Meaning hills together, mines together, all that fun stuff. I think I actually did pretty well. I'm pretty happy with what I got. I don't know how you guys feel, but I have 2 locations that have the exact same amount of gold. And the tiebreaker is the number of cards from a location. Is that what it is?
No. You choose which one you discard. We talked about that earlier.
Yep. No, I mean the tiebreaker at the end of the game for scoring.
No, you just go to the next.
Yeah.
Got it. Okay, so I have my mountains and my river is 10 total gold. So I am going to dump the river. So my 10 gold nuggets from the river are all going to go away as fool's gold.
Yep. I have 10 as my majority, which is from the mountain. So all my mountain cards will be gone.
Yep. That's probably a good idea. Just put them on the deck just to get rid of them.
So yeah, that's fine. All
right. And my lake had 10, so my lake is out.
Interesting. We all had 10.
Yep.
Did anybody get a complete set of gems like Ryan and I?
Boy, that narrows it down.
So Ryan and I each get 15 for our full sets, whereas mm-hmm. Chaz is going to get 10, I believe. Yep, 10 for 4. And then we add our points together. Survey says... Ryan?
I have 39.
Oh, I have 37.
Oh, no.
Chaz, tell me you did it.
Hold on.
Math is I'm your doing friend.
math faster. Let's see. What did you have, Ryan?
39.
I believe I ended up with 43.
Really? Oh, man.
3, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 15, 24, 28, 33, 43 for Chaz.
Oh, Chaz! That's amazing. Chaz did such a good job. Look at the high numbers he's got there. I mean, he raked in the gold while we were getting all the gems.
Yeah.
Well done. Ladies and gentlemen, the major miner. Is Chaz. That
thank you. Thank you for that nugget of wisdom.
Oh, well done. Oh.
Saving that one the whole game.
Nice. So that is Fool's Gold. And that was an awesome game of Fool's Gold because I knew it was going to be tight, but I didn't know it was going to be that tight. Like Ryan and I were only 2 points apart chasing after all the gemstones. And Chaz just basically said, if I get them, I get them. Not that
Chaz
big of a deal.
Chaz gets the golden pickaxe.
That's you do. Yeah. You do.
Indicating that you are now the Tabletopia champion.
Does that make him a fool? Or does that make him a champion at Fool's Gold? Or I don't know.
Makes me the king of fools.
The king of fools. I would definitely give you that title. That would be good. awesome. So that was Tabletopia. That was Fool's Gold on Tabletopia. If you'd like to learn more about Tabletopia, you can go to tabletopia.com. If you'd like to learn more about Fool's Gold or other games in the Passport catalog, you can go to passportgamestudios.com. Of course, you can find us on Facebook, on Twitter, on Instagram by searching for Passport Games. But if you haven't checked out our others, like we had mentioned earlier in the casting of the video, we talked about Quartz and we talked about Simeric being on our YouTube channel as well. If you go to YouTube and search for Passport Game Studios, you'll find us there and you'll find other playthroughs. Don't forget also, we have the Adventure Awaits podcast that Ryan, Chaz, and myself will periodically do every other week. Chaz, where can the lovely viewers find our podcast?
That lovely podcast can be found at all over the place. It's on Libsyn with other podcasts, but we're on iTunes. We're on Google Play Media now. We're on Stitcher. So, and also on the Passport website and Facebook pages. We'll have links to them there.
Awesome. So I think the next one, if everyone wants to maybe whet your appetite, we're going to be playing a game of They Who Were Eight, which is soon to be coming to Tabletopia. So be on the lookout for that one. But in the meantime, I think Ryan and I are going to cry over our gems and congratulate Chaz on a well-played game of Fool's Gold. So thank you both very much for joining me. And for everyone who watched this, thank you very much. Leave a comment below if you have questions. We'll do our best to answer them as quickly as possible. And Chaz will wreck the table as he ceremoniously does at the end of every game of Tabletopia.
Don't know how I got that reputation. That's not me doing that.
Yeah, it is. It's you.
That's me doing that.
I know. I blame Chaz, though. It's all his fault. It's the running joke. So. Awesome. So well, thanks so much. Guys, do you have anything, final last words about Fool's Gold?
No, this was great.
Yeah, I love this game, and this one was no exception.
Awesome. Well, thank you all for watching, and we will see you next time. Play more games.
Peace.